The leader of opposition in parliament, Matthias Mpuuga, has used the occasion of his first 100 days in office to say that the National Unity Platform, the party that he belongs to, is open to joining the Inter-Party Dialogue, or IPOD, but their concerns should be addressed first. Speaking today, the leader of opposition, who is responsible as the first steward of the opposition members of parliament, also pledged legal support to MPs Alan Sewanyana and Mohamed Segrinya, who are currently incarcerated at Kitale prison and are facing charges of terrorism over the killings in Masaka.
The National Unity Platform, NUP, declined to join the Inter-Party Organizations for Dialogue, IPOD, which brings together parties with representation in Parliament to dialogue on issues affecting the country. While interfacing with the media today at Parliament, the leader of opposition, Matthias Mpuuga, announced that NUP has not given up on IPOD, provided its fears are allayed.
We also agree to the fact that as political parties that have a duty to generate political consensus in the country, we can belong to the collective. If you scrutinize the statement we outed on our reluctance to join IPOD, we were very unequivocal in as far as our concerns are related to the IPOD.
Mpuuga noted that political parties in IPOD have failed to deal with issues like human rights violation meted against supporters of opposition, which is why they are taking their time to generate consensus over the matter.
So many of our members were injured, some were killed. We are pursuing justice to the families. Is it that the regime will change its nature? Are they honest? You probably could ask them as to the depth of their honesty. I do not know. I wake up every day to force them out. Whether that will be done with a bouquet of flowers or with other weaponry, that's not an answer for me. I wake up every day to do what is my stride.
Speaking at an event to mark the first 100 days in the office of the leader of opposition, Mpuuga condemned the arrest of the two members of parliament, Mohamed Segrinya of Kawempe South and Alan Sewanyana of Makindye West, in connection to Masaka murders, and pledged to extend legal support to the duo.
We came out very clearly and demanded that since they were arrested, after gathering intelligence, we await their prosecution. We demanded for a faster and quicker, transparent trial of these comrades. But we also warned that we hope this is not the tall grass the investigators have been looking for to hide away from their eternal incompetence, because they have never prosecuted such high-profile cases successfully.
The leader of opposition expressed a concern over the delay by parliament leadership to repeal a motion of 10th parliament which adopted the backlog of Auditor General's reports without scrutiny, which motion has rendered parliamentary accountability committees idle with no business to transact.
We believe that this is a very important motion, because the issue is that some of the accountabilities were not scrutinized by parliament. And because of that, we are saying that we cannot simply carry the report of the Auditor General as conclusive. Can I even explain, colleagues, that on a number of times, when you go through the report of the Auditor General and you invite the indicted witnesses to come and testify on the report, many times the reports do not change.
Opposition has devoted the first 100 days to building unity and planning their legislative agenda. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.